Exoanimals. Exoanimals are the third and last multicellular clade to evolve on Reccembra so far. They are heterotrophs and mostly get their food from the marine snow produced by the discophytes at the ocean's surface. While exoanimal anatomy greatly varies between species, all based around a central tube, evolved from the cell blanket their ancestors were made out of, curling up to connect its edges. This central tube is made of hexagonal structures made from multiple cells, called compartments. Most of these compartments are made up of a single generator cell, which makes more cells, surrounded by worker cells, which break down nutrients, and collector cells, which absorb the nutrients. But in some species, they have started to specialize into tissues with different functions, such as making new cells, collecting nutrients, and transporting said nutrients to the other compartments. All exoanimals started as two gametes, each containing a different part of a full cell, which fused to create said cell. This starting cell then forms the first compartment, which begins making more compartments. Eventually, the exoanimal embryo takes the shape of a solid cylinder made out of multiple compartments. It is only once this cylinder has reached the desired length that the true central tube begins growing, half of it from each of the cylinder's sides, until the creature is fully formed. When the organism has reached maturity, all of the outer compartments, in the case of unspecialized exoanimals, or all the reproductive compartments, in the case of exoanimals with tissues, start making gametes, which are then expelled into the water around the creature. While males and females only make one type of gamete, there are also hermaphrodites which make both, meaning that they have to first release one, then the other, to avoid self-fertilization. The order of the gamete expulsion varies between species. Tuboids. Tuboids, as their name suggests, are simple exoanimals which only consist of the central tube and some setae. Said setae only grow inside the tube near each end, and are made up of unspecialized compartments. Tuboids are filter feeders, using their setae to capture falling marine snow and slowly digest it by expelling enzymes. As all of their body is made up of the same kind of compartments, all of their body can digest food, although only the setae can keep it from sinking. They can't swim, meaning that they have to be light enough not to sink, keeping their maximum size at around 10 centimeters, at least for now. Pipes. Pipes are another early exoanimal clade. They descend from a group of tuboids, and so have very similar anatomy. However, pipes do not float. They are attached to the ground with special roots, which grow from one end of their bodies. Since they are still a young clade, these roots haven't had much time to specialize, and so are not very effective. Strong enough currents can still uproot unlucky pipes and send them to the abyss below. Another adaptation pipes have and tuboids don't are the basal pores. These small holes around the base of the organism, as the name, are actually an early take on a through gut, letting the nutrient-poor digested material, which sinks to the organism's bottom, float back out again. Zooshrooms. Another tuboid descendant, although a much changed one at that, is the zooshroom. Zooshrooms are the first multicellular detritivores to evolve on Reccembra, and in only 2 million years, they have managed to colonize most of the seafloor, from the coastal tidal pools to the coralliform full soil of the abyssal zone. They are older than the pipes, and so have had more time to evolve their roots into actual structures, not only used to stay attached to the soil, but also to absorb the nutrients from it. In this way, they are very similar to Earth plant roots. However, the zooshrooms are not plants, and are only distantly related to the discophytes of the surface. Since they get all of their nutrients from the ground, zooshrooms have sealed both their ends shut, making them look even more plant-like, and also making a water pocket inside their bodies, which they can use to store nutrients. Suckers. The last sessile descendant of the tuboids are the suckers. Like pipes, they only have one opening. However, in suckers this opening is pointing downward, letting them suck up the unicellular organisms and the detritus piling up on the seafloor. Because no exoanimal has evolved any kind of muscle yet, suckers are stuck in one place after they become too heavy to float as zooplankton and fall to the ocean floor. Meaning that for the rest of their life, they slowly dig a hole beneath them, burying themselves as they slowly eat away at the soil. Since expelling gametes from all of their body would be a massive energy cost considering most of the gametes released in the hole would die, suckers only release gametes from the top part of their skin, giving them more of a chance to float far away and find other gametes. Bagbugs. Moving on to floating exoanimals, bagbugs make up most of the zooplankton in the Protocene. They are not direct descendants of any of the current tuboid species, however their ancestor was pretty similar to them. They are the smallest exoanimals by far, with the biggest specimens only reaching 1 cm in length. They feed by collecting bulgrass and other small discophytes in their body cavity, and then digesting them by releasing enzymes. Smaller bagbugs have bodies similar to those of pipes, only free-floating, but larger bagbugs had to make sure their food wouldn't float away through their one opening, so they evolved a larger stomach and a smaller mouth, making sure any slight shaking of their body wouldn't spill the collected discovites back into the water.